This is Dear Mama Sal, and today we're going to do a slow cooking thing, and I thought I'd take you along with me. Of course, I only remember this after I've got everything going, but in the slow cooker there, I have got two beef tenderloin last night, I got it on the brain, which I dredged in flour first. I put in some leftover wine. I also put in some, I'm trying to think how much, probably about a cup. I put in about a quarter of a cup of maple syrup. I've also obviously put in some sliced onion. And just because I thought it would make a really nice change, I put some blueberries in there. I had some frozen blueberries in the freezer. So I put like a cup of frozen blueberries in there, which I thought would give it a great taste. I've also put in a little bit of pisto mixed up with water, and obviously the flour that the pork is dredged in will also help with the thickening. So I'm going to let that cook probably for about 4 hours on low, as you can see, 4 to 6 hours. I'll see how it's doing after four. And then for vegetables, I'm going to do onions and apple mixed together in a skillet, which I thought would be really tasty, and probably just some plain rice, because we've got lots of different flavors here, so we don't need to mess up too many more flavors. So hopefully that will be an unbelievably tasty meal, and I'll let you know when we get to the next point. Now you can probably see how they're getting really a nice colour now. I'm going to take the top off them and just let them brown a bit. But they are beautifully done. We're just going to caramelise some more. And you can see that the carrots are done as well, because I can cut through them easily. Yeah, so now the next thing we're going to do is caramelize a layer of apple. And I think what I'm going to do is to sort of make it into one dish, where I'm going to do a layer of this caramelized onion and carrots. And then over the top of it, I'm going to do a layer of apple. I think I'll use a bread tin. Not a bread tin, but a bread Pyrex to put it in, so that it will be a nice different vegetable. I must tell you that it smells absolutely wonderful. I've got 2 hours left on the pork, and the pork is just about done. You probably want to have a look at that, right? Let me just show you here. So How does this look? What we've got is, it's just been cooking really slowly. It's in its, all its own juices and lots of them, which my household really likes, lots of gravy type stuff. Now the only thing is that the onions aren't done yet, so as soon as I have finished the broadcast, I'm going to take the pork tenderloins out and just keep them warm, and then I'm going to sort of really quickly heat up the onions if they're not perfectly cooked by then. But the rest of it's looking good, and I have to tell you, it smells wonderful. No doubt about it. All right, so there we go. And I'll show you the next bit when we do it. Okay, everybody, so this is what it ended up looking like. The meat was just falling off the, it was difficult to carve it because it was so beautifully done. And the caramelled apples, onion and carrots are underneath there. And some rice. Yum! Thank you.